Human-caused climate change has had a huge impact on the ocean. There's increasing sea temperatures, there's ocean acidification, more storms, and rising sea levels all interact to have a devastating effect.
Sea level rise is going to damage all coastal ecosystems, all coastal communities, and it's going to be a very, very dramatic shift that we're going to see.
The coastlines, the smaller islands, are the most vulnerable communities to the impacts of climate change and biodiversity loss.
Sustainable seaweed farming can help fishers adapt to climate change by buffering declines in overexploited fish stocks, reduce the effects of ocean acidification and deoxygenation, and also by helping to diversify livelihoods. My name is Nick Hill, and I'm co-founder and CEO of Coast4Sea.
The good thing with seaweed farming is it does not require fresh water. It does not require big space, so it does not compete with other food crops that we need to grow. And it does not also require fertilizer and pesticides. The carrageenan extracts are used in food, pharmaceuticals, cosmetics, and even personal care like toothpaste and sunscreens. Globally, seaweed farming could provide a big opportunity for us to actually break away from the petrochemical-based systems. I am Amado Blanco. I am co-founder and COO of Coast4Sea.
These small-scale fisher-farmer communities in places like the Philippines have been producing seaweed as part of their culture for many decades. We saw an opportunity to leverage their ability with seaweed, tap into this opportunity with the growing interest in the seaweed market, and help to drive positive change for the ocean, the climate, and for the people in those communities.
Resilience in these communities is very important. A lot of these communities have seen the direct impact of climate change. Odette is the strongest typhoon to hit Bohol in the last 100 years.
Kanang tiguang sa evacuation. Ay, kung ilara ninyo, nga, ang dagat mo abot diri, kaya tiguang na lang ko.
Nagkuha na gid siya, taga-kuha na, taga-liog na sa kuha, naglangoy na itong doon sa konserva. Baybay yun, sa tubig at during sa kuha. Naguba ang mga balay, pambot niya, mga gusto na mo na kuha, nawala.
Regenerative farming is helping secure sustainable sources of livelihoods for communities as a mechanism for restoring degraded marine ecosystems to ensure that these coastal communities are really prepared, really have the capability to recover or at the very least survive after the impacts of climate change.
Ka-observe ang kuan, kami ng mga kuan mananagat, ang isda mo na nasa kuan. Layo niya. Panahon po mag-init siya, katong dool sa kuan, baybayon ng isda, nga matay po siya.
We have experienced declines in fish catch over the last few decades. So when people are heavily dependent on fishing for their livelihood, then that's a very bad thing.
Di nasama sa unang kuan, labi na karon nga gi bagyo murag kanang kuan. Ang mga isda ba kay murag nangawa. Siguro pud tungod tingali sa ato ang kuan kanang naay mga puy-anan sa isda murag naguba pud siya sa bagyo.
Sustainable seaweed farming, that's very important to the communities that we're working because that provides them an opportunity to supplement fishing.
So ang panggusto dako kayo ikatabang sa kuan pamilya kay kuan pod ni alternate sa pagpangisda kay nakita na turo ng kuan nga medyo nihit na ang kuan sa kadagatan ng isda.
Restorative seaweed farming is a good platform for ensuring that people are not only earning money to meet their day-to-day requirement, we are also empowering communities so that they can support efforts to secure marine biodiversity and fish catch in the long term.
We have helped to set up more efficient value chains for seaweed in the Philippines by shortening that value chain, reducing the number of players between the seaweed farmers and the eventual markets. We help to increase access to price, help them to achieve a fair price for the products that they receive, and we help them to access technologies, seaweed farming methods that increase their production and ultimately benefit their income.
So nakinahanglan mi anang mga kanang PC, mga labi na gyud ang seedling. Mogid na siya, maora magid na siya amo ang kasagaran nga kung ano katong pang-usok niya kabilya, katong mga but niya. Ang amo pong gigamit nga imbis mamutol mi og mangrove, so katunang mga katong bag-o na tong gi-adapt nga katong sa eco-seaweeds na to, maayo gito siya kay ang tubo sa atong gusto, nindot kay tubo, gikan sa tumoy, padong sa pikas tumoy, parihas ragid siya tubo.
Seaweed farming can be a good tool for communities to adapt the impacts of climate change. There are studies that suggest that actually seaweed farms can sequester carbon. It can also offset the impacts of oxygenation.
The oceans have been underestimated in their importance in fighting climate change. Carbon is stored in coastal ecosystems in the sediment, and the sediment has no oxygen. It's capped, and that carbon doesn't return to the atmosphere.
Seaweed is very effective at storing carbon because it grows faster than any plant, so it takes up carbon incredibly quickly.
Oceans can play a really important part in the circular bioeconomy because we can capture CO2 from the atmosphere, grow it in a kelp or a seaweed, and then make products that we use in our society.
Small-scale fishing communities live in all coastal areas of the ocean, and they are the people who have the knowledge of the marine resources and how to restore the ocean. Our vision is to mobilise the collective action of these small-scale fishers to help restore the oceans and restore the nutrient balances that are so important for our climate. By working with them, harnessing their collective knowledge and setting them up in the right way with the right tools, then they could have a huge impact on restoring the world's oceans and climate.